One of the first things you do when you wake up in the morning is go and look in the mirror, because hopefully you're going to brush your teeth. So when you look in the mirror, what do you see? Maybe your eye color, your messy hair, or your cheekbones, or like my mom says, the gray hairs just won't go away. So where do you get these traits from? Maybe your grandma, your mom, your dad. So take that and then look in your mental mirror. Like, what makes you who you are inside? Where do you get these traits from? Maybe like love or patience, kindness, or a sense of humor. As writing this speech, I've learned that the people I surround myself with are a reflection of who I am. One of the most important reflections in my life is my father. I'm like crying. Okay. My dad is one of the most, is the wisest person I know. And looking in my physical mirror, I look exactly like him. People tell me that all the time. My mom even gets upset sometimes because people have to ask if I'm her daughter. And even, we have the same taste in music. There have been plenty of times where my mom yells, "Y'all, go to bed," because we're up listening to Luther Vandross or Earth, Wind, and Fire. But as I said earlier, my dad is very wise. And I feel like that's a reflection of me. Now, I'm not saying that I'm wise, the wisest person in the world, because I'm only 18 and obviously I haven't graduated yet. But the most important lesson he's taught me is to never doubt myself. Now, I'm 18, teenager, everybody knows there's a lot of self-doubt going around. And my dad always tells me, for Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. That sticks with me throughout everything I do. When I'm sitting over there, I have to say it in my head about 3 or 4 times. Now, for example, my driving test. I had to take it a couple of months ago because I procrastinated a little bit. It was the second time because when I went to the DMV the first time, the brake light went out right when I got to the DMV. So I'm sitting in the car, nervous, trying to figure out, okay, am I gonna pass? Simple things, you have self-doubt. My dad turns around and looks at me, he's like, "Shae, you're gonna be fine, don't complain, you're gonna be great, because you're gonna go down there, you're gonna drive, turn around, and kind of come back and wanna go to Chick-fil-A." And lo and behold, I passed my test and I went to Chick-fil-A right after. I'm so grateful to have a father who teaches me that I should never doubt myself and that I should always believe in who I am. Now, my mother, on the other hand, she's more of a hands-on teacher. My mother has taught me patience and love. Now, I have 4 other siblings, and my mother has constantly said patience is a virtue. I'm so happy that she has taught me to always be patient with other people because I will always want that myself. And to always love people, because hate, it brings frown lines. She's also shown me how to be a woman of God and to always live a fulfilling life. John 15 says a lot about love, but the scripture that sticks out the most says, "These things I command you, love you one another." My mother always pushes that on me. She always tells me to always, always love, because someone always needs your love. Now, my siblings, they have taught me strength. Not physical strength, but mental strength, because I've had to endure 17 years of pranks and being tricked into washing the dishes because it's fun to play with the bubbles. Seeing them grow up has taught me that no matter what I go through, I can always come out stronger than where I was before. Specifically, my older sister, Amber, has taught me, guys, I'm crying. Taught me to always, always laugh and to never cry about things. Now, I have a loud laugh, a very loud laugh. There's been plenty of times where Caroline Brothers would come down to me after class and say, "Shae, I heard you laughing in the comments," and then other people would be like, "Yeah, yeah." Laughing has become a hobby for me because I've learned that I should always laugh instead of being mad about something, because laughing is just easier. My sister, I've gotten mad at her plenty of times, and I can't even be mad for that long because she'll come quote Shrek, and then I'll start laughing again, and then we'll be fine. My sister has recently gotten married, and the most important thing that he needed to do for her, in my opinion, was to make her laugh, because she loves to laugh. And I am blessed to say that he makes her laugh, and he makes me laugh, and we all laugh too much. And he's a very humble person, and I'm so glad to have him as my brother-in-law. My grandma, she is amazing. You know, in this universe contest, when they sing that she is beauty, she is grace, that is the epitome of my grandmother. She has taught me three very important things: to always be modest, to always give the respect that you want to receive, and to never wear heels that you can't walk in. Now, these people up here, they're amazing. I've been at Oakridge for a while now, and I cannot fathom the fact that I'm going to be leaving them like very, very, very soon. They have taught me to always laugh and to always love. They support me as much as my parents do, and my parents came to football games even though I only gave the boys water. They taught me to always be myself, and they taught me to never be upset. And I don't think I could be, because one of them is going to yell Shea Butter or Shea Burger during the day, and I'll probably die. They taught me that I'm in love with poetry, which is something I never thought I would be into. They taught me to always go outside and smell the flowers, even though there are bugs, because a flower can be very beautiful. And they taught me to always smile, because it can help someone else and also help me. I'm so blessed to say that God has given me these amazing people in my life to love, have joy, and express who I am through God. 1 Corinthians 5:33 says, "Do not be misled. Bad company corrupts good character." And I think I can say that these people and the people I previously talked about have helped my character become very good. So, back to the whole mirror thing. Remember to always surround yourself with good people. And like you are a reflection of others, others are a reflection of you. Thank you.